Hi everyone, my name is Gail and I am a program coordinator for Girl Scouts of Michigan Shore to Shore. Our council serves more than 30 counties in western and northern Michigan. And to anybody watching from across the United States or around the world, thank you for joining me in this program. Today I'm going to be showing you all how to build a buddy burner. Now, a buddy burner is a homemade camp stove that gets you thinking about camp cooking in a different light. Girl Scout seniors can use this activity to fulfill step 3 toward their adventure camper badge. Now, with any camp cooking, if you have long hair, it's important to make sure it's tied up, wear some closed-toed shoes, and also make sure you have some protection for your hands. I like to use leather gloves whenever I'm cooking with an open flame. So, let's get started. So, a buddy burner is kind of a homemade stove. Now, this isn't going to be the most powerful, most efficient tool for cooking, but it's something simple that you can craft and make up at home. And using it to heat up some tea, you can use it to reheat a meal that you've already made. But it's not going to be anything too powerful that you can cook a whole meal, say a one pot meal, but it's enough flame and enough heat to rewarm something. So for this project, you are going to need some corrugated cardboard. Now this cardboard is like the cardboard you get when you order something online. It's that thick stuff. It has the ridges in it. You don't want anything like you get from your cereal boxes that's going to be too thin. So you're going to need cardboard. You are going to need some empty aluminum cans. Of course, with the paper taken off of them, because when you use your buddy burner, you don't want that to light on fire. And for most stoves, they use a tuna can. All I have, however, is a short old cookie tin. You want something that is short, not anything tall like this can. So a tuna can is short and round. This one is just a little bit bigger than a tuna can, but it's all I had, so this is what I'm gonna use for my buddy burner. So the one thing you're gonna start with is estimating about how deep your can is. You're going to take your cardboard, and this one I already pre-measured. I know it's about an inch deep. And you're gonna start drawing lines on your cardboard to cut. So, start off. And you're just gonna go all the way down your cardboard, adding lines of the same thickness. And again, it doesn't have to be perfect, so don't worry about your cardboard being perfectly straight. Then, you're going to take your scissors and start cutting these strips of your cardboard. Now you can kind of see here how I've got mine drawn out. And cutting those strips. Now depending on the kind of can you use, because mine is a lot bigger, I needed a lot more cardboard. With the tuna can, you probably won't need that much. But you're gonna take these strips of cardboard and you're gonna start to roll them into a spiral, starting as small as you can possibly go. The tighter the cardboard, the better. And you're going to wind it into a disc. There we go. It'll look like that. Now with each strip that you do, you're gonna keep adding and adding and adding this cardboard into this disc. And then this is gonna live in the middle of your empty tin. So this is what it'll start with. And at the end, this is what it will look like, full of cardboard. So the one thing I forgot to mention for this is you're going to need some wax. Now you can find craft wax from the store, beeswax if you want. You can also use some leftover candles. So have an adult help you source that wax. Make sure you're not taking anyone's favorite candle. And have an adult help you reheat that wax. You can use a double boiler method, using a stove with the help of an adult, anything to melt that wax, because you're gonna take it and pour it into this tin to fill all these grooves of the container. Now, I don't know if you can tell if I hold it up, how you can see it looks a little bit different. But adding this wax to the cardboard is helping this buddy burner burn slower. So when you light it, the fire isn't over in a second, it'll continue to burn for longer and better heat up your food. So after that is all set and prepped, this one I made before, so we're gonna use this one. This is where your three cans are gonna come into play. Now for this, because I didn't have a decent flat surface, I'm gonna be using a stabilized aluminum trash can lid. You can use these also for making a campfire if you don't have a fire pit. So with your buddy burner in the center, you're gonna take these three cans, placing them around the outside. And so that will create a rack to rest your pot on. Now, again, because my tin is a little bit bigger, my pot also has to be a little bit bigger so that it will stay resting on top of these cans. But after you've got that ready to go, again, working with your leather gloves, you can light this buddy burner with the help of an adult. Now, I realize you probably won't be able to see it from where you are, but right now I've got a slow, low flame going on my buddy burner, and this can live on top. I've just got some water in there that I'm gonna heat up for tea. So for all you seniors working toward your adventure camper badge, building a buddy burner with the help of an adult is one of the things you can do to fulfill step three. Now that you've built and tested your buddy burner, you've learned a new outdoor skill that draws on resourcefulness and thinking outside the box. Ask yourself, what might you do differently next time? Or what would you like to learn more about? Perhaps more primitive camping or wilderness skills? Feel free to check out Girl Scouts at Home or the Girl Scout Shop on girlscouts.org for additional activities, or check in with your local Girl Scout Council or troop leader. I'm so glad you learned something new today. Thank you for joining me with this activity. Have fun learning some more outdoor skills.